guys, it's Chek here and I am back to bring you guys another video. Today's video is a makeup look. It's actually a does it really work though makeup look, which is my first, using the Phoera, I think that's how you say it, cut crease stamp. I saw this on Instagram and I just had to get it, and it came in a while ago, but I'm just now getting the chance to make this video. But it looks like this, and apparently it does a good job at cutting the crease, and we're gonna find out if it actually does today. If it does, then this would probably be a pretty good beginner's tool. I kind of did a DIY on like a beginner's tool for cut creasing back in the day, literally last summer. It was one of my first few videos, but that was something I actually made. This is something you can purchase. And well, right off the bat, I'm already noticing that the front thing here spins and comes off. Well, like, there's creases on here, which tells me that it's supposed to screw on, which means it's not like a manufacturing mistake, I guess you can say. It screws back on, but not very tight. I don't really want it to fall off on the floor like that. This goes on my face. Well, that's my first impression on this so far. Now we're just gonna hop right into makeup. My face is already done, obviously. I don't usually go no highlight, like full matte, but like this is just natural glow, like coming through the foundation. Like, I'm not wearing highlighter, and I don't know if I'm gonna keep it that way, but that's besides the point. That's not what this video is about today. But okay, since I did my face first and everything else first, I have my lids primed already, and I'm just going to smooth out the creases that were made because it's been primed for a while without me actually doing my makeup on it. I just want the creasing to be gone. So I just took the brush that I applied the concealer with, and I'm just patting down the creasing. I know a lot of makeup artists don't set their concealer anymore, but I do sometimes and I don't others. Like, it just depends on what my mood is like, how much blending I'm trying to do, how much effort I'm trying to put into it. Today I'm not setting my concealer. All right, to first start out this look, I'm going to go into my Take Me Back to Brazil palette. I do use this palette a lot, but that's because it's one of my favorites. And I'm going to go into the black right here, and I'm going to just pack that into the crease.
Hey yo. Garbage shit for the Gaudian. That is what I was IDing. That was real love I was in.
But now that I've packed the black into my crease, I'm going to go over that with one of my like Anastasia Beverly Hills two-sided brushes. And I think I'm just going to blend it and see if I want to add another color to the top of it, or if I'm just going to keep it's a black over top. Honestly, I don't really want to use my Anastasia brush. Alright, I'm gonna use my MAC 210 instead to do that. Picking up a little bit more black from the Take Me Back to Brazil palette, I'm just going to start at the edge and work my way forward into the crease. I don't know why I like to work from the back to the front, but like, I just feel safer. Like, it just feels so much safer doing that. It like warms up the concealer a little bit. So it's like, the concealer is always a little tacky if you're not going to set it. So like, if you move it too quickly, it can kind of get gunky or like streaks left in it. Don't get me wrong, it definitely does what it's supposed to do though, which is make the shadow more pigmented. It definitely does that. Now that I've smoked that out a little bit, I'm going to go into my ABH Subculture palette, and I'm going to grab this grayish shade over here called Mercury. And I'm just gonna work that right above the black. You know what I kind of just realized about this? What if someone's eye isn't this big? Like, I don't know, mine is, but I'm trying to see how much of how much concealer I'm gonna have to put on this, because I only want my crease to be cut to about right like here, and this is way bigger than that, so I might have to just put it on like the bottom. I definitely expect to have to clean up this cut crease a little bit, because I don't know, we'll just see. Okay, so my approach for this is going to be concealer right on the cut crease stamp. I'm going to use my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. This is in Honey. If you guys haven't noticed, I actually like cutting my crease with concealers that are lighter than me. I don't really know why, I just like it. It's, I don't know. That's just how it is. So. Okay, so I'm going to just put the concealer right. I'm gonna start out at the bottom. This is actually really hard to like look at in the camera and do. But like, I'm just gonna do this here. And y'all, I can't do that anymore. Y'all get the point. You guys don't understand. I'm so scared right now. I really want this look to turn out good, because I'm doing a Snapchat pictorial on it, and I've already started the pictorial, so I really want it to turn out good. Oh, and if you guys want to see my Snapchat pictorials, my Snapchat will be down in the description. Just make sure to add me and you will be in the loop. So I cut the crease like this. I left a little sliver on top because, like I said, I don't want the cut crease like all the way up there. I just want it like about right here. So hopefully that's about like right there. And let me just do this before the concealer freaking dries. I'm kind of holding it on for a little bit longer, trying not to move it at all. And I'm just going to pick it up this way. Really? We ain't here for the messing up Chiquina's makeup today. I'm just gonna put a little bit more concealer on the same exact spot that I put it before, and I'm just gonna do it faster without rambling so much so that the concealer doesn't dry. Okay, that time the concealer was actually completely wet. I just feel like this stamp kind of absorbs the product and it doesn't transfer very well from the stamp itself to the eye. We'll give it one more shot, and if this does not work, honey, I do not know. Okay, I kind of made it a little smaller. Like, I just don't want this to mess my makeup up. It's really just absorbing the product. It does not transfer very well at all. I literally just did that in like 0.2 seconds out. I feel like this product isn't really good for wet things. Maybe it would work better with like a pigment. I saw a video on Instagram of someone using it on using like pigment and not concealer. But maybe I'll use a little bit of pigment on this look just so we can see how it works with pigment instead. But as for now, I'm just going to cut my crease how I normally cut my crease, since it was deciding not to work. Going in still using my Urban Decay Naked, oh my god, whatever. Urban Decay Naked Concealer in Honey. I'm just going to cut the crease using one of my Bobbi Brown brushes. Now I'm gonna go into my Makeup Forever Artist Forever single eyeshadow. This is in the shade Auburn. And this is going to go on the cut crease area. Now I'm going to go into my Huda Beauty Obsession palette. This is in the shade Electric. I'm going to grab the red right here. This is more of a like purplish red, but that's going to go right next to the Makeup Forever eyeshadow. Now I'm going to go into my Zulu palette from Juvia's Place. And I'm going to grab this orange up here and put that next to the pinkish purple color.
That is what I was hiding. That was real love I was in. Ain't no reason to pretend. Got a shit for the ghost songs and feelings that I was guarding. Heavy on my mind. All my friends about
The Makeup Forever eyeshadow kind of oxidizes into a orangey shade, and I actually really wanted it to be red. So we're gonna go into my BH Cosmetics Take Me Back to Brazil, and I'm gonna grab this red right here. I don't know why I didn't use that from the jump, because I actually know how this one pays off, and it actually looks very red. Now I'm gonna go back into my Huda Obsession palette, and this time I'm going into the yellow in the middle, and we're going to finish off the cut crease part with that. Okay, so I'm just going to add a little bit of pigment because I like this look as it is already. I'm going to put eyeliner on too, by the way. But I'm going to go into my MAC pigment. This is in the shade Whisper Pink. Of it, I'm going in with like a brush approach. Over here, I'm just going to dab the pigment on, and once I do that, I'll show you guys how that looks. Now that this is done, let's put that on the lid and see how that goes. Oh my god. No, we're not doing it. Not today, honey. Of course, it got the pigment above the cut crease, but it didn't get any on where I actually wanted it to be. So since that was not working out, I'm going to go into my NYX Crystal Liquid Body Liner. This is in the shade Crystal Champagne, and this is going to go right above where I cut the crease. Okay, now that that is done, I'm going to go into my Kat Von D Tattoo Liner. This is definitely one of my favorite eyeliners out there. And I'm going to just do my wing liner. Now I'm going to go into my Fenty Beauty Kilowatt Freestyle Highlighter Duo. This is the Mean Money and Hustle Baby Duo, and I think I'm going to go into Mean Money because, like I said, I'm trying to, I'm just in a matte type look today instead of the highlighter. Not even matte, because like I still got that little cute natural glow, but it also could be the primer that I used today. I use the NYX, I think it's called Born to Glow or something like that, primer. And this is my second time trying that primer. But so far, I do see what it's talking about when it says Born to Glow, because I do feel like it does like glow through your foundation a little bit, which is a very good thing, because that's what it's supposed to do. I'm gonna go ahead and add some of the Kilowatt highlighter to the tip of my nose and the bridge of my nose. I think I'm just gonna put some highlighter on anyway, because I can't just not. Who just doesn't wear highlighter? Like, I love highlighter. And this is a matte highlighter, so technically I'm not even wearing highlighter. Yes, it's so pretty. I love this highlighter palette or duo. I didn't want to get it at first because I didn't think I would like it. I'm not a natural highlights girl, but... Alright, so now I'm going to go into my NYX Retractable Eyeliner Pencil. This is a white, it's a crayon. This is a white eyeliner crayon. And I'm just going to line my bottom waterline with that. Now that that's done, back into my Take Me Back to Brazil palette, we're going to grab this black and line right under the white eyeliner. Now, right under the black, I'm going to go into the red from my Take Me Back to Brazil palette and line right under the black and just smoke it out a little bit. Now, going back into my Kilowatt highlighters, I'm going to go into the more glittery side, which is called Hustle Baby, and I'm going to just tap some of that into my inner corner. Now I'm gonna do my bottom lashes and mascara on them with my CoverGirl Total Tease mascara. I just went off and did my lips. I used the MAC Retro Matte in Carnivorous and the Stunna Lip Paint from Fenty Beauty to make this lip. And that is it for this look. This is the finished product. I really hope you guys like this look as much as I do. I really enjoyed filming this look for you guys and trying out the Phoera cut crease stamp. I don't really like this product, honestly. I don't think that it does what it's supposed to. The transfer on it was really bad. Maybe if they made it out of more of a plastic material and not like a rubber, it wouldn't absorb as much product and it would actually be able to transfer onto my eye. But I'm not a fan of this product, and I wouldn't really suggest buying it. Honestly, I think the DIY one that I did few videos back what works better than this does, honestly. Let me know if there's any other way I can use it. If you have tried this product and you like it, let me know if I'm using it wrong or something. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Share the video with all your friends. That means so much to me when you guys do that. And make sure to follow me on Snapchat, Twitter, and Instagram. All that will be in the description, and I will catch you guys in the next video.